المحبة وتنشرون السلام، ثم تدعي بأن الغرب هو من نشر الإرهاب. يعني هل كانت أمريكا موجودة حينما كان رسولك يقتل الناس يمينة وشمالا؟ هل سوف تتهم أمريكا بأنهم هم من قتلوا أحفاد محمد؟ هل ستتهم عائشة بأنها كانت عميلة للCIA؟ ماذا تقول يا هذا؟ صراحة المسلمين أرى فيهم عجبا عجابا. ثم يقول أن الإسلام يعني ليس فيه تعصب. أنا أتحداه وأسأله، لماذا في إيران الآن مساجين مسيحيون؟ كل جريمتهم أنهم بشروا بالدين المسيحي، وهناك قسيس سوف يعدم قريبا فقط لأنه ترك الإسلام وأصبح مسيحيا. ثم تتكلم عن التعصب، أنت في أمريكا تتكلم عن الإسلام وتبشر في الإسلام، ولا قتلوك ولا ولا شبه لك.
البث المباشر أنت مسموع يعني حاليا، تفضل.
طيب بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
نعم.
يعني أنا أتعجب هذه الكمبيوتر بها حساسية فقط حينما وصل إلى إسرائيل. على كل حال الموضوع الذي نتحدث إليه، لا يوجد هنالك CIA في وقت رسول الله، لكن كان هنالك صهاينة، وأرى إلى هذا اليوم هنالك صهاينة يدافعون عن إسرائيل ويهاجمون إيران ويهاجمون
إسرائيل. تمتلك مئات من الرؤوس النووية وفي كل يوم تهاجم بلدا عربيا وأنت تسكت عنها أيها الظالم. وأما إيران فلا تملك أي رأس نووي وتخافون منها، لأنها على حق ولأنها إلى تدعو إلى الإسلام وإلى الوئام. على كل حال
No, actually, everybody have different attention. But our attention, I'm not responsible on the other. Our attention is for peace. We're praying for a peace and ceasefire in Middle East for all sides to stop the killing of innocent people.
He's praying for peace. In the coming video, you will see that he is happy for the good news, which is the destruction of Israel. He is saying he is praying for peace in the Middle East. You see how they lie? I will hear more of him and then you watch my debate with him.
Confused about where you stand.
Very true. Well, I will help you to remove that confusion, my friend. First of all, I never was a pro-war. I was pre-liberation. I asked for liberation of Iraq. I never said for
just a question. The shake of lies. How you want to liberate Iraq from Saddam Hussein? I will give you three choices. You tell him to leave and he will leave. You give him a ticket to go to Las Vegas and he will move out of Baghdad to Las Vegas. Or you send an army. You see how trying to play with your mind in a very stupid silly way. They think that we are stupid people. He is a brew of free Iraq from Saddam Hussein. Saddam Hussein who have more than 1 million soldier. How you can do that? You know, and everybody knows that at that time George Bush was going in war, and he worked at that time for the government. But let me tell you why he accept. He is a Muslim Shia. You see, for him this war worked for the benefit of the Shia. So what? It's legitimate for the Shia. Not, you know, they hate American. This is why when the American they went there, they asked them to leave after they are done with Iraq, with Saddam Hussein. They used the American to kick Saddam Hussein out, and he's telling you he's a pro peace. How you can be pro-peace and at the same time you want to free Iraq from Saddam Hussein by supporting George Bush in his war? And don't fool yourself again. They never supported George Bush. They supported him to go to the war so he can do the job for them. We did the dirty job for those Shia. They dream to have Iraq under their control. The Sunni Muslims, they are controlling Iraq for the last almost 1,000 years. And if not George Bush, the Muslim Shia, they will never have Iraq in their hand. Now Iraq is under their control forever. That's it. They are the majority of the country. They are more than 75, and the Sunni, they are eliminated. They became nothing.
Occupation or a war against Iraq. That's one thing. The second thing is, yes, I am happy to see Saddam die because he's an enemy of God. He's an evil man, and he is an enemy of humanity.
If we ask him, is Ahmadinejad is an enemy of God? Is he? He will never say that. Actually, you will see in the coming video that he prays Iran, and he think Iran, they are the good ones, the government of Iran, and Ahmadinejad is a great man, and we hate Iran because they are fair, and they are people who they are legitimate. They are the one who is presented the truth. This is his view of Iran. This is how faithy this man is. Because if you are an American, everybody knows that America and Iran are enemies. The Iranian, they shout every day, 3 times a day at least, saying death to America. The first thing they do in the morning, and death to Israel. So how come the Iranians are not evil for you, but Saddam Hussein is? Because he's a Muslim Sunni, and they are trying to get rid of him.
Troops from Iraq after they done the good job and liberated Iraq and stopped the occupation. And actually, right. I got one last question.
I want you to answer yes or no to these two questions. Is Hezbollah a terrorist group, and is Israel a nation of peace?
Well, first of all, I believe all the nations are for peace, whether they are Lebanese, whether they are Muslim.
Is Hezbollah a terrorist organization, sir?
This is your idea as a political or as a... You know what does Hezbollah mean. I support the people of God.
The
believers, whether they are Christian or Muslims or Jewish.
We appreciate your coming on the show.
Let us see who is the people of God for this man. He support the people of God regardless if they are Christians or Muslims or Jews. We will see if this is true or he is lying. Let us expose him. Now, Hannity, he asked him very clear question. Are you with or against Hezbollah? What do you think of Hezbollah? He said Hezbollah is a word in the Quran. Hezbollah, a word means people of God. I am with people of God, regardless if they are Christians, Jews, or Muslims. This is how they try to fool you. You see, like they give you an answer which is not an answer. He is with people of God, regardless if they are Muslims, or Christians, or Jews. But the Quran says the story in full, that he is trying to fool you. Chapter 5, verse number 56, and this is the verse, let me show it to you with the Muslim translations. You will see in here that the people of God, the parties of God, those people are the one who they support Muhammad, the one who fight with Muhammad. You see, they take a side with Allah and His Messenger. Who is Allah and His Messenger? It's Muhammad. So do the Jews take the side of Muhammad? No. Do the Christians take the side of Muhammad? No. So the Hezbollah is always the Muslims. The liar, he was trying to convince us that, you know, Hezbollah is people of God. You know, yes, people of God in Islam, and those are the Muslims and the Muslims only. This is why the Quran is full of verses says, kill them wherever you find them. Kill the Christians, kill the Jews, kill the infidels. So they try to fool you, and they think, this is what the Muslims, they think, that you as a Western is an ignorant. Because they learned, you know, sadly, from your society, that you people, you know, you believe anything is said to you. Obama says Islam is peace. George Bush says Islam is peace. Hillary Clinton said Islam is peace. And then Islam is peace. And here we go. He's giving you a nice smile, a smiley face. You know, he's laughing. He's a peaceful person, etc. Now, if we go to the explanation of the verse about Hezbollah, chapter 5, verse number 56, you will see clearly that not only they are people of God as a party, they are the one who will be victorious over the enemies. And who is the enemies? If we go to the, you know, to chapter 9, verse number 29, we will see who is the enemies of Allah, who the Muslims been ordered to fight. 29, here we go. And then you will notice that those are the enemies, which is the Christians, which is the Jews, which is the people of the book. People of the book mean the Christians and the Jews. Here we go. Fight those who, from the people of the scriptures, who is the Jews and the Christian. Do you see it? It's not my translation. This is the official government website of the Kingdom of Jordan. This is their translation. This is their website. This website belongs to the king himself. No kidding. And this is Ibn Abbas. So fight who? Fight the Jews and the Christians. But he was saying to us, the people of God, they are the Christians and the Jews too. You see how they lie to you? Don't ever trust a Muslim. Anyway, in the coming part of the video, you will see how he loved the Christians and the Jews, specifically the Jews. You see, he said that he is with the people of God, but at the same time, he will attack Jerusalem, and he will kick the Jews out. And he, for sure, he mean, you know, when he said the, you know, the word in Arabic, kicked, it means he will cleanse, you know, he will kill everybody. So let us see what he said in the coming part of the video.
ولكن أبشرك ببشارة في القرآن قالها الله تعالى وإذا جاء وعد أخراها هنالك كرة أخرى لأن الصهاينة هم ظلم الآن وهم يقتلون الأبرياء في فلسطين والعملاء من أمثالك يدافعون عنهم وعن جرائمهم لذلك أقول لك إن القرآن يبشرنا بعودة المسلمين إلى القدس وقريب وإن شاء الله سوف يطرد من أمثالك الصهاينة من القدس الشريفة التي دنسها الصهاينة من أمثالك والأعوان إسرائيل من أمثالك فأبشرك ببشارة بشرنا بها رسول الله محمد من عند الله تعالى في القرآن الكريم سوف يأتي اليوم القريب الذي يدخل فيه المؤمنون إلى القدس ويطردوا من أمثالك و